Hey, this is Jason Suecof, and you're about to get your fix of. What's up, junkies? Rob here with a pretty cool dude. This guy is a producer, a guitarist, a vocalist, a lover. Jason Suecof. Hi, how are you? Thank you for spending some time with us.
Oh my God, dude. I am beyond excited to be here with you.
What?
Yeah, dude. You are really taking my life to the next level today.
First of all, I hold the mic, all right? Let's get that straight.
All right. Well, what about her?
No, the dog is not part of this interview. Okay. Name your dog Stinky. Let's start with that.
Okay. She's a terrific, terrific dog. Dude, I feel like an asshole for grabbing the mic now. I feel like a complete dick, and I like that.
That's the headline. Yeah. Jason Suecof grabs the mic.
Yes.
It's going to be trouble.
It's dude, all I care about is Stinky right now. I don't even care about you making fun of my dog's name.
Okay.
All right.
But let's get serious for a second.
We'll get serious.
Farts. You fart a lot. No. Let's be serious. Yeah. No, you've produced a lot of stuff.
Yes.
And why don't you just tell us how you got started in the, like, producing bands to begin with?
Basically, you know, I opened up a studio in my basement in Connecticut, like, in 94, and I did a lot of bands in the local area. One of the bands was Red Tide, who Justin Foley now drums in for Killswitch, but he was in a band back then. They were kind of like a proggy, cynic band, and, you know, there was just, you know, a lot of hardcore bands back, you know, in the Connecticut area, and maybe some from New York, I can't remember, but it was many years ago, and I just kept doing it, and then I came down here to go to recording school, which I dropped out of and, you know, put back into the studio, and here I am.
And it's more of a hands-on approach as opposed to paying other people.
Yeah, dude. Hands-on.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying, dude? Put them on me. Let's fucking go downtown.
Maybe after the interview, but right. Back to...
I'm ready, dude.
But also, you also, like, one of the first bands you did here was Trivium, and, like, that's a band that... You've obviously worked with a lot,
yeah.
And since then you've done, like, a lot of other bands, like Whitechapel and Atheist and other ones that I can't think of right now. Why don't you give us a little collection of bands you've worked with recently?
Recently, I did the Death Angel, and I just mixed. I did the Famine, and man, I mixed a. Uh oh.
Thinking. Basically, most of the metal release.
I've been mixing. I'm mixing the Born of Osiris right now, and it'll be done probably tomorrow, I would imagine. That's gonna be pretty. It's an amazing album. It incites feeling inside me when I listen to it.
Right. I actually want to ask you, like, you work with a lot of bands that have very different sounds. Like, how do you go in? Do you go in with, like, different mindsets? Like, how do you change it up?
If I'm mixing, you know, I'll do my initial mix and I'll send it to the band and I'll be like, hopefully they'll either feel it. And if they don't feel it, I'll be like, I'm willing to change whatever the band wants to do. You know, I want to make the band happy. It's mm-hmm. really about everyone being happy and not just like one person, you know, mm-hmm. that's how it is for me. So I want to make everyone happy. But at the same time, you know, I think there's a point where you got to be like, okay, you know, something sounds weird.
Right.
And I need to tell you, that's
right.
All.
What about, like, when you're producing, like, a record? Do you go in differently if it's, say, Whitechapel than it is, like, Atheist?
I just always put myself as if I'm, like, I put myself in the position as if I'm a member of that band. Uh-huh. You know, because I just kind of understand what that band's about, and then I would act like if I was in that band, like, what riffs would I write, or what, you know, what would be best for the band itself, rather than just kind of, I take a more, like, musical, what would I do is a musical approach, you know?
Right.
So it's, yeah. You know, then I kind of suggest stuff to the band. They're either into it or they're not. And nothing hurts my feelings. I just kind of throw out, you know, stuff. And if they're into it, cool. I like making fun of metal. It feels right.
I don't think you pretty much, it's not only making fun of metal. We're talking, of course, about Crotch Duster.
Yeah.
I feel it's like a metal history lesson. Like, you nail every genre in the span of one CD.
It's fun, dude. It's all about just having fun. It's like, I don't think you should be too serious about, you know, anything. Like, you just don't want to be too serious about anything in life, unless, you know, something horrible's going on. But,
right.
You know, it's just like, everyone in metal's so serious. It's like, yeah. There's nothing. It's like, so what? Let's just
hang out. Make jokes about mammal songs. And fucking. Well, was that just how it was born? Like, you were just hanging out and you were like, I'm going to make a silly metal record.
No, me and my buddy Eric, who, we just kind of like hung out, and he was like writing a lot of lyrics, and you know, it started off like we wanted to do like a Tenacious D sort of thing, and it turned into more of like, you know, just like, I don't know, it took a year to do. Like, we didn't, I think it got like named Crotch Duster maybe in the middle of it. It's really hard to like remember exactly how it all came together, but it was like done over the course of a year, and then I got Pro Tools, and then we remixed it, and then we just kind of, oh yeah, and then it came out on Willowtip. Jason from Willowtip put it out, and that was super cool. And then he put out that with the Gefarnum CD, like almost at the same time, I think. And then after that, I recorded Trivium, and I kind of disappeared from like playing, you know, doing my own stuff. But every once in a while, I'll do like a little joke thing. We did like the joke El Nino song and the joke, I think that's it.
Well, there was like a Shadows Fall joke song.
Like, see, like everyone, it's like, it doesn't like exactly sound like Shadows Fall, but right. I guess like my friend named it that, and then that's just what it became. It's, I guess like there's certain aspects that might sound a little bit Shadows Fall-y, but if you're going to say that, then you can, you know, say like it sounds a little bit like this and that too.
I know exactly what you're saying.
Yeah.
Not really, but let's just, yeah, Capernaum is another thing that was, it was an awesome record, and you did have Matt Heafy on the vocals, but could we ever expect new music from either of those bands?
If I could just, maybe. I mean, I'm working on new stuff here and there, but I can't say yes definitely, but I can't say no definitely, and I don't want to say, I don't want to say no, and I don't want to say yes, because I don't want to close the possibility to anything, but I also don't want to, you know, piss anyone off and say it's coming.
Right,
because it might not.
We're just gonna edit out, so it's just gonna be like, it's coming.
That's all you need.
Basically, it's just, if you have the time, you would totally do it, right?
Yeah, maybe it's. Well, then I have to decide whether I want to do like Capernaum or Crotch Duster, because like Crotch Duster, I feel like it's kind of like that first thing. I don't want to have to try to beat it. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to have to. It's so much pressure. I don't want to have to do that.
Right. How do you top that record? It is a bit of a masterpiece.
Because I did it as a joke, and I wasn't thinking about it. And I know that if I do it again, I'm going to like think about it and be like, this has to be like this. This has to be like this. And it's already ruined. I just ruined the whole next album. It's not going to be good. It's not even going to be funny.
Right.
You're going to return.
Maybe that's what you should do. You should make a serious Crotch Duster record.
No. No. You know what? No one will like it.
An acoustic Crotch Duster.
I would like to mic up myself shitting for 4 days straight and then speed it up to see if there's any messages in my ass. Let's go!
Well, on the Crotch Duster record, you have Richard Christie do a little intro, and you've worked with him. How did
He used to live with me back in like 2000, back when he was practicing with Chuck for the Control Denied that they were working on. And he's just a really good friend of mine, man. And he was like, I mean, he was a dedicated Howard fan even before he was on Howard. Like, he would tape the whole Howard show on like a VCR tape, and then like bounce like the best parts onto like a regular tape. And either way, he was a dedicated fan, and he started doing all like the phony phone call things. And I think he called in one of the first times from here.
Well, you do a killer Richard Christie. Could you tell the fans goodbye in your best Richard Christie?
Hey everyone, I was kind of hoping you'd all stick around so that you could watch some more metal interview stuff, but I gotta go watch my favorite movies, Halloween 1 and 2, and listen to Striper for 6 hours nude, and then hang out with Sport. All right.